A to-do list is a simple and effective tool used to organize tasks and activities that needs to be completed within a certain time frame. It also helps individuals to stay organized, prioritize tasks, and manage time effectively. In other words, you can say it helps us in time management on an efficient basis. In today's video, we will see how we can create a fully dynamic to-do list in Excel.
Hi, my name is Vijay and you are watching Office Monk. Let's start the video without any delays.
This is a to-do list which I have already created in advance. In the very beginning, we have got serial number, after that task or to-do. I'll put some activities over here. As soon as I typed my first activity, I got my serial number. I'll drag this down. So all the serial numbers got filled automatically. Target date, we will have to do the entry manually. When the entry of date was done, day got visible. Priority will be managed through dropdowns. Very important, less important, and not important. I'll select one. Status. Again, the status will be managed through dropdowns. In status, I have kept three options: done, pending, and ongoing. In case you want to add more, you can. I'll select pending. As soon as I selected pending, the whole row got highlighted. Now I'll select ongoing. The word ongoing got highlighted in orange, but the whole row was not highlighted. This time I'm going to select done. And as soon as I selected done, the task or activity got strike through, means this task was completed. Let me do the changes in first two also. Done. And the highlight got removed and the activity or task got strike through. If I'll select done over here also, we got the same result, means we got the strike through. When we will insert any task or to do, the number of tasks will be visible on top. If I'll remove all the tasks, the number got zero. I'll undo this. If I'll remove these tasks, the number got changed to 6. When I'll remove status from here, done is showing 0. I'll change this. I'll do it done. And we got 1. If I'll drag this down, we got the number as 7. I'll put some status as pending also. And we got the number as 4. I'll put 2 ongoing also. And the ongoing task became 2. And over here also, it's showing 37%. If I'll add some done over here, the number got changed to 79%. And the bar also got changed to green. I'll remove this. And now it's 37%. On the top, we have got dropdown for years. And over here, we have got dropdown for daily, weekly, and monthly. So you can create your to-do as per your choice, means daily, weekly, or monthly. Let's start creating a new sheet now. I have opened a new sheet. We will start from B4. This will be serial number, task, / to-do, target date, day, priority, status, comments. We will select the whole row and we'll take all the things in center. We will select the whole sheet and we'll take all the things in mid and we'll change the font style. We'll do as Times New Roman. We'll take this in left side. We'll adjust the column size. We'll select this and we'll change the color. We'll change the font color. Over here, we will insert the formula for serial number, plus or equal to sequence, bracket open. Along with sequence, we will use count A. Count A, bracket open. We will click on first task. We'll press Shift plus Control. In case you are using MacBook, you will have to press Shift plus Command and press down arrow key. Close the bracket twice and hit Enter. We'll go up and we got some error over here. To avoid this error, we will go to formula bar and we'll insert the criteria of if error. If error, bracket open, we'll go to the end, comma, double inverted comma twice for blank, we'll close the bracket and we'll hit enter. So the error got vanished. We will put some activity over here and we got serial number as 1. I'll drag this down. And all the serial numbers got filled automatically. I'll drag this till 10. Now I'll select this. We'll go to home and we'll create borders. Target date. We have to insert target date manually. So our first date is over here. We'll click on the top and we'll take all the things in center. we'll right click the mouse, we'll go to format cells. From here, I'll go to date and we'll select a desired date format and we'll do OK. So we got 10th of January 2024. We'll right click the mouse once again, format cells, and this time I'll be going to custom. We'll take this up. Over here, we can see the date format. I'll remove 1M from here, means earlier it was 4M. I'll keep it as 3M now and we'll do OK. So we got 10th Jan 2024. Day. Formula for day will be plus or equal to text bracket open value. We will select target date as our value, comma, double inverted comma, DDD means T3 times, double inverted comma close, bracket close, and we will hit enter. Now I'll drag this down. If there is no target date, we can see Saturday. To avoid this, we will click on the first day, we'll go to formula bar, and we'll insert the criteria of if bracket open target date is equal to blank. For blank, we will insert double inverted comma twice. If the date is blank, comma, what we want in return? We want blank. So we will put double inverted comma twice once again, comma, we'll come to the end, close the bracket and hit enter. Now we will drag this down. Perfect. Priority. For priority, we will create dropdowns. I'll select this from top to bottom. We'll go to data, data validation. From here, I'll select least, source. In source, we will type manually. In case you want to take the source from any other sheet, you can. Very important, comma, important, comma, less important, comma, not important. Whatever priority you want to put, you can. Over here, you can type up to 250 characters. Now we will do OK. And our dropdown is ready now. We will increase the size of the column, status. For status also, we will create the dropdown. I'll select from top to bottom. We'll go to data validation. From here, I'll select list, source. I'll type manually, done, comma, pending, comma, ongoing, and we'll do OK. So the dropdown for status got created. Now we will do conditional formatting for done, pending, and ongoing. I'll select the whole sheet. We'll go to home, conditional formatting, highlight cell rules, equal to, and over here, I'll type ongoing. We'll click on the dropdown, customized format, font, and I'll select a desired color. And we'll do OK. OK. So ongoing got highlighted in orange. Now we will select this. We'll go to home, conditional formatting, new rule. From here, I'll select classic. And from the dropdown, we will have to select use a formula to determine which cells to format. And our formula will be plus or equal to. I'll come down, we'll select first cell, we'll press function F4 three times, is equal to double inverted comma, done, double inverted comma close. We'll take this up, we'll click on the drop down, customized format, we'll go to font, and over here we get the option of strike through. We'll click over here, we'll go to color, and from here we will select green color, and we'll do OK. OK. So when it's done, it got highlighted in green and got strike through. We will do the changes over here also. Done. And we got the same result. Activity 2 also got strike through and got highlighted in green. I'll undo this. Now I'll select the whole sheet. We'll go to conditional formatting, highlight cell rule, equal to, and over here I'll type done. We'll click on the dropdown, customized format, font, and from here I'll select green color. We'll do OK. So the word done also got highlighted in green. Now we will highlight pending. And for pending, we are not going to highlight the specific word. We are going to highlight the whole row. So we will select this from activity or task till status. We'll go to conditional formatting, new rule. From here, I'll select classic. And from the dropdown, I'll select use a formula to determine which cells to format. And the formula will be plus or equal to. I'll take this down. I'll click over here just under status. We'll remove the dollar from the center. Is equal to double inverted comma, I'll type pending, double inverted comma close, we'll click on the drop down, customized format, we'll go to fill, and from here I'll select the red color. Font, we'll select font color as white, and we'll do OK. OK, so the whole row got highlighted. If I'll select pending over here, the whole row will be highlighted. Now I'll click over here on B2 and we'll select till E. We'll go to home and we'll merge it. Now I'll click on G2 and we'll select H2 also and we'll merge it. Now I'll select all and we'll put some color over here. We'll change the font color. We'll select as yellow. We'll make the row size bigger and we'll increase the font size. This will be to-do list / itinerary. We'll click on next cell and over here we will create drop-down for years. We'll go to data, data validation. From here we will select list and over here we will type years from 2024 till 2030. Don't forget to put comma between 2 years. We'll do OK and the drop-down got created. We'll select 2024. We'll take this in center. We'll go to home and we'll take this in center. Over here, we will create drop-down for daily, weekly, and monthly. We'll go to data, data validation. From here, we will select list. In source, we will type daily, comma, weekly, comma, monthly. And we'll do OK. So the drop-down got created. We will select weekly. I'll select this and we'll change the font color. We'll go to home and from here I'll select impact. We'll select this once again and we'll create outside borders. We'll make row number 3 bigger. We'll go to view and from here we will remove grid lines. Now we will insert one more sheet and this will be settings. We will click on B2 and over here we will type total task. We'll leave C as blank, we'll come to D, this will be done. We'll leave E blank and we'll come to F, pending. We'll leave G blank and we'll come to H, this will be ongoing. We'll take this little bit left, we'll select the whole sheet, we'll go to home and we'll take all the things in center and in mid. We'll make row number 3 bigger, we'll take blank cells closer. We'll press Ctrl and we'll select blank rows. And we'll take it closer. We'll put some color over here. We'll make this light. For done also, we will select some color. We'll make this light. Pending, we will select red color. We'll click over here and we'll go to more colors. And from here, I'll select light red. And we'll do OK. Ongoing, we'll change the color as yellow. We'll put light yellow over here. Now we will put borders for this. We'll press Ctrl and we'll select this and we'll make this bigger. We'll make the row size little bit smaller. Now we will put our formula over here. Formula for total task will be plus or equal to count A, bracket open. We will go to our first sheet. We'll click on the first task or activity. We'll press Shift plus Ctrl and down arrow key. We'll press function F4 and the cells will be locked. We'll close the bracket and we'll hit enter. So number of tasks got visible. Now we will come to done plus or equal to count if bracket open. We will go to first sheet. We'll come up. We'll click just under status. We'll press shift plus control. In case you are using MacBook, you'll have to press shift plus command. And we'll press down arrow key. We'll press function F4 and the cells will be logged. Comma. We'll come to our settings sheet and we'll click on done. We'll close the bracket and we'll hit enter. So we got the number as 1. We will go to our first sheet and we'll increase the number of done. Now it's showing 4. We'll copy our formula. Control C or command C. We'll come to pending and we'll paste the formula over here. We'll hit enter. We'll click on the number 4. We'll go to formula bar and we'll delete D2 and we'll select pending from here and we'll hit enter. We'll go to ongoing, we'll go to formula bar and we'll paste the formula which we have copied earlier. Ctrl V or Command V. We'll delete D2 from here and we'll select ongoing and we'll hit enter. So two pending and one ongoing task. Let's check in our format. One ongoing. Let's increase some ongoing tasks. So here we can see two ongoing tasks. I'll increase number of pending tasks also. So total task pending is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 and ongoing is 2. We'll come to settings sheet. Over here we can see 4 pending tasks and 2 ongoing tasks. Means our formula is working perfectly. Now we will go to view and we'll remove grid lines from here. We'll select total tasks and numbers. We'll press Ctrl C or Command C. We'll go to our sheet 1. We'll click over here. We'll go to home. Over here we get the option of paste. We'll click on the drop down and from here we will select linked picture and our picture got visible. It is linked from task or to do. If I'll remove some tasks from here, number of tasks got reduced. I'll undo this. We'll come to settings sheet. We'll select done. Ctrl C or Command C. We'll go to sheet 1 and we'll click over here. We'll go to home, paste linked picture. We'll take this to right side. We'll go to settings. Now I'll copy pending, Ctrl C or Command C, sheet 1. We'll go to paste, linked picture. We'll take this to right side. Now I'll click over here. We'll go to settings and we'll copy ongoing, Ctrl C or Command C. We'll go to sheet 1, paste, linked picture. We'll take this to right side. Now we can reposition as per our requirement. Now we will go to settings sheet. We'll click just in front of ongoing, we'll leave I as blank and we'll click on J. We'll take this closer, we'll increase the column size, we'll select both and we'll merge it. Over here we will insert the formula for percentage and the formula will be plus or equal to total done divided by total task and we'll hit enter. So we got 0.4 over here. We will go to home. We'll come in the center and we'll select percentage sign. So it's showing 40%. We'll go to home and we'll change the cell color. We'll do as red. Now we will go to conditional formatting. And from here we will go to data bars. And we'll select green color. We'll go to conditional formatting once again. Manage rules. We'll click on edit rule. Over here we get the option of minimum and maximum. From the drop down, I'll select number. And we'll keep the number as 0, means minimum number as 0. Now I'll come over here and we'll select number over here also. Over here I'll delete 0 and we'll type 1 and we'll do OK. OK. So when it's 40%, half part is green. I'll increase number of dones over here. We'll go to settings sheet and now when it's 100%, it's totally green. We'll come to sheet 1 and we'll undo this. We'll go to settings sheet, we'll copy this, Ctrl C or Command C, we'll go to sheet 1, we'll click over here, we'll go to home, we'll click on the drop down and we'll select linked picture. We'll resize this and we'll reposition in extreme right. We have to create borders for this. So to create borders, we will be going to settings sheet. We'll press escape, we'll go to home and we'll create borders for this. Just one thing to remember. Whatever changes will be done over here, it will be visible in our first sheet. Let me do some changes over here. I'll change the color of this and we'll do as white. No fill. Let's go to our sheet 1 and over here also the color got removed. I'll come to settings sheet and we'll undo this. Now I'll select this. We'll go to home and we'll change the font style. We'll do as impact. We'll increase the font size. For this also, I'll increase the font size. Change the font style. Impact. Perfect. We'll come to sheet 1 and we'll rename this as to-do list. We'll reposition this. And our format is ready now. I'll provide link of this file in description box. In case you want to download, you can.
I'm sure you must have loved the video. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. See you soon with a new topic. Till then. Bye-bye.